Hi, everyone, and welcome to the new moon in Taurus reading. Okay, this new moon is going to have the energy of Taurus all around it. And I love that because I'm actually a Taurus moon. So let's get right into what does that mean, right? That energy, what is that Taurus energy? We're going to start with Taurus's key phrase, and that is I have. So what exactly does it mean? And where is it going to show up this new moon cycle? All right. And how can you use it to your advantage? We're talking about the energy. So the energy, let's get started. It's slow and steady. I always refer to it as steady Eddie. It can also be very loyal and productive and determined and practical. Tauruses love to plan. They love gathering facts and understanding them. And then they love moving on to the next step. Another thing about this energy is that its motivation is centered on resources. So, for example, money, possessions, the best way to use them, the best way to earn them, the best way to save them. And of course, there's always a plan for that as well. Okay. So that's just something else. Now, there is a word of caution about Taurus energy. And that is that sometimes the determination can go to the extreme and stubbornness actually results from that. And there tends to be maybe, a lack of being flexible for change in some situations. So just keep in mind those shadow attributes, right? So now we know what the Taurus I have energy is. Let's see where it's going to show up for each zodiac sign, because you're going to take that energy and you are going to, with new moons here, new beginning, planting new seeds, new cycles, and planting wishes for manifestation, right? So, and I'm going to say it's a very determined and someone who loves to plan. So this is a type of energy you like during a new moon, okay? Regardless of where it's showing up. Now, what I always suggest is that you watch for your rising sign first, because it's going to resonate the most. But if you do not know your rising sign, you can always watch for your sun sign. And if you want to book a personalized new moon reading based on your very own birth chart or natal chart, there is a link to my website. Just go to the about section there, and I believe you will find that. It will tell you what it's all about and how much it costs. So that's everything I want to tell you about the Taurus I have energy right now. I will see you in your reading. Hi, and welcome to the second part of your new moon in Taurus reading. This is the pick a card. We're going to have two piles for you, okay? Pile one is the black obsidian moon, and pile two is the moonstone heart. Okay, so choose pile one, pile two. You can choose both because these are going to be additional messages to what you've just read for your rising or sun sign, okay? So you may want to plant these seeds in addition to what it is you've already read, or in place of if what you read isn't resonating or you feel you don't need to work on that for this particular moon cycle. So let's get right into it. I will see you in one of the piles or both. Hi to those of you who chose pile one or this beautiful black obsidian moon. Okay, I'm just going to set this over here and we're going to get right into your reading. So the first three cards I do, I kind of have them, I think of them as going together, right? I ask spirit to kind of give a message together. It could also be considered overall or individual. We'll see once the cards come out. So pile one, let's get your first card out here. And it is Aquarius. Okay, so it's using this Taurus energy, all right? Because the energy stays the same. It's Taurus energy for this new moon. But rather than what maybe you've just read, this could be you using it somehow in your 11th house. So if you want, go back and read for the 11th house, okay? Because that is all about your friends, your support systems, your social circles. It's about networks and alliances. It's technology, okay? And humanitarianism. So where can you plant seeds in that area using that very steady, eddy, yet determined, focused, productive, practical energy of Taurus? Maybe in some way, if we think of it with networks and alliances and technology, but even your friends and social circles, it may even have something to do with your income, your financial responsibilities, right? How you earn your income, how you save, you know, how you invest. It can be anything like that. So go back and look at this now for your 11th house as well, okay? Let's just get another card here. And it is, I can never pronounce the name of these, but it is guardianship and protection. Do not fear to lose what you already have. Your heart is a guardian and your soul the brightest star. With Aquarius here and this particular card, what I want to say is maybe for some of you, it would be manifesting in, look, we have Libra and we have Scorpio. Maybe it is manifesting in some new friends, a new friend group. Maybe it's manifesting in a new support circle for yourself. Maybe it's manifesting in the networks and alliances that you will need to succeed somehow when it comes to your finances, being that this is Taurus energy. Maybe for some of you, you may have to protect yourselves somewhat from some of the friends that you currently have or social circles or groups, right? Or maybe when it comes to investments, you may want to read the fine print. Okay, so you can take that message as is. Let's get one more card coming out here. Because Libra is all about your relationships, your one-to-one relationships, from family to love to friendship. And maybe when it says do not fear to lose what you already have, you may already have some good solid friendships happening or support people or groups, whatever it is. But there may be, you know, sometimes there's always one bad apple that upsets the cart, right? That spoils the bag. So maybe there's something you need to revisit there. Because maybe, again, with Taurus energy, they don't have the same
core values or core belief systems that you have, right? So you may want to think about that a little bit as well. Let's get another card here. Focus. Mm-hmm. Really stop and take the time, okay, to really give this some thought. I guess it would be, don't do it willy-nilly. If you know that maybe there are some people that you need to protect your heart from, right, as it says here, your heart is a guardian, right? And maybe you need to protect your heart from someone or something even that's going on in one of these groups, then you know what? Focus. Don't do it willy-nilly. You know what? Don't just do it, you know, rush out and just start, you know, getting rid or dumping people or groups left, right, and center. Really give it some thought. Have some really focused, inspired change, okay? Because in the end, you're doing what's best for you. And if you do it based solely off of ego here, then you may end up losing some people or things or groups that maybe you shouldn't have, all right? So I think that's why they're like, focus, you know, really pay attention to it here. Just, you know, just don't jump the gun on it, all right? Now, let's get into the rest of the messages here for you, pile one. And maybe what you're asking to come into reality here, you know, planting the seeds, asking spirit, God, source, universe, whomever to help you, is to, by focusing, figuring out who or what it may be. Okay. All right. We had two come out there. We just need one. Sometimes they're messages for manifestation and sometimes they're just messages in general, right? So let's get another card here. Your dreams need a practical plan. Full moon in Taurus. But I talked about Taurus being practical, right? Determined. You know, they love to be productive. They love to plan. So you need a practical plan. I feel this does tie in here with this. We are dealing with new moon. So it's planting those seeds, right? It's asking spirit to help you. Look, this is my plan. Can you help me bring this to fruition? And you work together to do that. Let's get a tarot with it too. But again, we could say because this is Taurus, that maybe you want to look at your second house, which, as I said earlier, is all about your earned money, your earned income, your financial responsibilities. It can even be things like personal properties and possessions, and it can be about your core values and beliefs as well. So you may want to look at that for where you want to plant new seeds for growth. You know, do you need to get that new job? Queen of Cups. Okay, so this is something I believe that when you are planting your seeds here, if you decide to go into that second house area, this is something that needs to hit you on an emotional level, okay? It can't all just be up in your head. Taurus is an earth sign, which means, you know, quite often like to go to the mind, right? But you need that mind and heart working together. So this is something that needs to mean something to you emotionally. Also, listen to your intuition here with the Queen of Cups, because she is very intuitive. She is flow, right? It's that gentle flow between intuition and mind and ego working together. Also, do something that is going to be, maybe we could use the word, I guess, nurturing for yourself. Something that's going to allow nurturing to come in or come forth, I want to say. All right. But let's get on to the next card. I don't want to make these too long for you, pile one. So let's just get right in and get started here to the next. New moon in Taurus. Oh, wow. Okay. They're doubling down on the messages here. Okay. For you. So again, around that second house, if you have already read for your second house, they're just giving you the message. There's definitely something there that you need to be planting those seeds, going after whatever your dreams and wishes are in that area, right? Your dreams need a practical plan. Know your worth. Do you need to maybe get a job where you make more money because you are worth that? Okay. Do you need to find a new position because you're worth that? Do you need to move on? And out came this card to another company. Ten of Pentacles, wealth, because you are worth that, okay? You need to find your worth. You need to know what your value is. And I talk about it as in a job, because for most people, you're still of working age that are watching this. For others, it could be within your family unit. It could be within this friend unit. What's your worth, okay? What's your dream here? You know, this is about you, and they're giving you the Ten of Pentacles. If you can do this, I want to say, if you can pull this off, Taurus, there is wealth, there is abundance that is meant for you, okay? So just keep that in mind. But right now, we have 11th house, and we have second house. And again, if you've already read for those, because that's your rising or your sun, this is just additional. You need to focus in those areas, because sometimes we don't know, right? Like, that's why I do these readings. We're like, I don't really know where I should put my focus or how I should go about doing this. And that's why I do these, to help you, because with astrology, everything is about the energy of the planets and the moon cycles, and, you know, everything moving above us, okay? And it brings energy to us. So these would be the areas that will be the strongest for you this moon cycle, okay? That's why I do, when you're reading, that's why you're reading that. That's the area that's the strongest. But maybe for some of you, like I said, you've already been working on it. So you may want to, guidance from spirit here, work on some of these other areas, or they're giving you a very gentle reminder. No, you need to focus on your 11th. No, you need to focus on your second house, right? Okay, let's get another. Right here we have Dark Moon, the past. Because there's snakes on this card, and that reminds me of death and rebirth, transformation, right? They shed their skin. Maybe for some of you, it's time to let the past go. What have you learned from the past that you can now move forward with? You want to plant the seeds with what it is you can move forward with. The lesson that you've learned, now let's put it into action, okay? That's the message I'm getting from that card. You are going to shed what isn't serving you, like you do on a full moon, to make room for what it is that does. But I feel here with the past, it's saying, you know what? You have learned a lesson somewhere in the past. Maybe for some of you, pile one, you just haven't started acting on it yet. Now is the time. Look, it's time for healing, okay? To let go of that past, to move forward. You can think of it that way. It could even be, it's by doing this, you will find that balance, right? Here's that flow again. We've got the Queen of Cups, that flow, that beautiful ebb and flow between your intuition and your mind, everything working together. You could even say between, you know, the heavens and earth all working together. So I love this message for you. Let's get a couple oracles here to end it off. Well, one is actually another astrology card and an oracle to end this off for you, pile one. Okay. Capricorn. Capricorn. Scale mountains to gain a sense of achievement. Okay, I love that. All right, so we have that could be an individual message, like they all can be individuals, they can tie together. Again, you are trying to accomplish here, right? You are trying to achieve, Capricorn, brother to Taurus, okay, we could say. It's accomplishing, it's setting out to make your dreams, to plant seeds so that you are successful. And Capricorn is 10th house, so you may want to go back and read about planting seeds when it comes to your career. Any ambitions that you have, right? Anything it is you want to accomplish. Your reputation, what do you want that to be? Your responsibilities, maybe doing a better job at being responsible. You know, what it is you're known for out in the world and how you make your mark on the world. So you may want to plant seeds around that. So go back and read about that 10th house too. And one last card to just end this for you, pile one. I love this. Lots of stuff you can work on, like I said, additionally or in place of. I see the gateway is open and the pathway is clear. My journey begins. That's what I said. I'm putting this down here with this card. It is time for you to start fresh. Let go of that past like a snake. Shed that skin and start planting the seeds to move forward. Beautiful advice and guidance here for you, pile one. Thank you so much. If you feel inclined, please go look at pile two. You can never do too much, okay? So I will see you next in your, well, my other readings, if you watch those, of course, or in the full moon reading later in the month. Hi to those of you who chose pile two or this beautiful moonstone heart. We are going to get right into your reading. The first three cards I pull, I kind of think of they can sometimes be an overall or they can just be individual messages on their own or as a group. So let me just get started here. And remember, we're talking about Taurus energy. That energy does not change. This is just going to be if you want to work on things or plant seeds, go after your dreams and wishes in different areas than what you just read for your rising or sun sign or both. Okay, so let's get right into this here. For you, pile two, it is the fourth house. I'm just going to read the card. It says, this is the house of origins, right? Here is where we see our home, our bloodline, feelings of safety, comfort, mother figure, tradition and lifestyle. It also shows where we come from. I belong. Okay, because the fourth house is all about your family, your ancestry, right? It can be your literal home, all right? Or where it is that you come from if you still don't live, say, where you were born. But even you can trace ancestry back. And again, it's about nurturing yourself. It's the fourth house is ruled by Cancer. This card just came out, okay? So I'm going to let that stay. It's ruled by Cancer, which is all about, you know, flow, intuition, nurturing, caring, comforting, all right? It's about caring for yourself, self-love. It's about having compassion for others. You're very much the mother sign of the zodiac, and that's why the mother is even represented in this house, okay? So if you need to plant new seeds, if you have dreams and wishes and you want to plant the seeds for them around the fourth house, okay? So go back and read about that. With it, we have this card, and I can never pronounce these names, so I'll just hold it up. And this is Leo, so a bit of Leo energy coming in here. Prestige and mastery. May your strength be acknowledged so respect shines among others. Maybe for some of you, you are that person in your family, I want to say, that's kind of, with Leo here, the shining star, okay? You're the one that everyone goes to. You are the reliable one, all right? You are the mother hen of the family here. You are, like I said, the one that everyone goes to. So if that resonates with you, okay? Don't be afraid to allow yourself to shine for that reason. This is just a nice message for you, okay? Don't be afraid to accept the acknowledgement and the accolades, maybe from friends or family, especially for having that role, okay? And this just came out. Maybe you're the peacekeeper, okay, here, pile two. Maybe that is something that you do and you do well. You are the peacekeeper. You are the one that makes everyone else feel safe and secure. Okay, so if that is resonating, then this is definitely your pile, all right? Okay, and maybe for some of you, I just want to say as well, maybe you need to focus on finding the peace, because if you are this person that everyone comes to, I feel like I need to say boundaries need to be set so that you have time out and you have peace. Going back to my energy reading for, no, wasn't energy reading. It was the Zodiac Taroscope reading for Cancer. The first one for this month is a lot about taking the time out and caring and nurturing yourself, not just the other people. So that could be an important message for someone who's watching this. Now let's get into some other cards here, okay, in tarot. Pile two. With that beautiful moonstone heart. I just love it. I know my lighting doesn't get the reflection on the crystals the greatest, but so pretty. Have faith in your dreams, waxing crescent moon. What I want to say here, the minute that I saw that and read it before I actually said it out loud, it was just, you have dreams too. I feel you are so supportive here. I feel like this is like Cancer's message, similar anyway. But again, you have pile two. Maybe for you, you, like I said, you are the caretaker. You take care of everyone else. You help them maybe achieve their dreams, but don't forget your own, okay? Have faith in your dreams. Don't forget your own. With the Devil card. What I like about this is don't allow yourself, okay? Don't allow yourself to be tied to everyone else's dreams and wishes and again, neglecting your own, okay? This is it. That's the message. It's important that they really want this message to come across to somebody who's watching pile two, maybe a few of you, okay? But again, for another house right now, actually, we have fourth house. You could also look at fifth house because I did talk about Leo, which is anything to do with planting seeds. What are your dreams or wishes when it comes to things like fun, creativity, hobbies, your children, what you do for entertainment, if you play any sports. It can be about dating, romance, and passionate love affairs. But the important thing is, remember this Taurus energy for this new moon. You're going to approach this, I feel, in a very determined way, in a very practical way, in a way that will be productive. The overall end result will be productive for everyone involved. And it's okay to gather up information ahead of time. Do some research before planting those seeds. That's also a very Taurus energy, right? Gathering the information, understanding it so that you can make an informed decision, right? When you're moving to the next step and the next step and the next step. So that's something important as well. And you can do it when it comes to this fourth house or when it comes to the fifth house. So read about the fifth house as well, pile two. Let's get another card here. new moon in Pisces, attune to the divine. That is getting in touch with your higher self, your inner self, your soul, right? It's getting in touch with your intuition and your dreams, your spirituality, your unconscious mind, all right? Anything that is hidden or unseen, the mystical and the magical. So go read about the 12th house as well and apply that Taurus energy when you want to plant the seeds for those different areas in the 12th house. Maybe you really, it's a goal of yours here, pile two, to really start getting more in touch with divine, with your intuition and listening to it. Okay. And you want to plant the seeds for that. Ask Spirit, God, Source, Universe to help you, or whomever it is for you to help you with that. Okay. And maybe you want to get more into the mystical and the magical. Maybe you want to do what I'm doing, right? You know, I do medium work. I also do, I'm an astrologer. So I do astrology charts for people, as well as card readings and mediumship readings, right? So, you know, maybe you want to get more into that. Use that determined Taurus energy to set forth on it. The Eight of Swords. I like this. Maybe for you, I want to say with the Eight of Swords, that's kind of closing yourself into what we can call your own self-imposed prison. If you look at some of the cards, it's like a person standing with the sword surrounding them. But there's gaps in those swords, so you could walk out at any time. There's really quite a big gap in one of the cards right at the front that you literally could walk out. The swords are there. You could cut off any of the loosed bindings that are around you, the devil energy, the things that are that you feel, that you think, okay, because it's swords, so that you think are holding you back. They want you to walk out of that, okay? Walk out of that and start working on this 12th house, the 12th house areas in your life. Okay, so go back and read about that. Very important. We just have a few more cards here before we end off for you, pile two. But the important thing here is remember, bring in, call in that energy from the new moon, okay? It's Taurian. It is determined. It's, you know, I have energy. So you have the determination, you have the skill, you have what it is that you need to help you plant these new seeds in these different areas. Knowledge, drawing down the moon. Yeah, it's pulling in that new moon energy of Taurus, right? You're drawing that energy towards you. It's funny, I just said that. That is where you are going to, well, I like it because I said about Taurus, this is interesting. I said they love to gather the facts, right? Figure things out to make a plan for whatever it is that you're going to do. So use your intuition, call upon spirit and draw that energy in from the new moon and use it, as I always say, to your advantage, right? Don't let a new moon or a full moon go to waste. It's a lot of powerful energy. And by doing it with your sun or rising sign, that's the energy that will be strongest for you, okay? This is just in addition to or in place of Six of Cups, the past. For some of you, it's remembering back to what it is that used to emotionally fulfill you. Could be recent past, it could be far past. It'll be different for each one of you. Maybe that is with this energy you're going to draw from there and remember back to, wow, this really used to make me happy when I was using my imagination and I was being and I was very artistic and I used to draw or I used to play music or I used to do whatever it was and that really made me happy. I need to start doing that again. Then that's what you're planting the seeds for, right? They're the metaphorical seeds you're planting for, you know what, to bring the good back in. So, message for you there. But let's get a couple of oracles here before we go. This is another astrology card, actually. And then an oracle at the end. So one more. Cancer, look back to that fourth house. For some of you hearing this message today, they really want your focus on the fourth house. Doesn't mean you still can't focus on the others or the one that you've already read for. But they're saying here, acceptance, an emotional phase or domestic development. Okay, they really want you to focus on that fourth house. Okay, so where can you really plant the seeds when it comes to anything to do with your home, your family, your ancestry, nurturing yourself and others, right? We talked about it, but not to the detriment of yourself here, of course. But they really want you to focus in on that, to start planting some new seeds. And for some of you, it could be boundaries, setting those boundaries, right? Okay, let's get one last card for you here, pile two. And then we are done for this moon cycle. Every day I bring radical self-love to my mind, body, and spirit. They don't want you to forget about you. Okay, so that's bringing that message home. So there's some different things in here, some of them tying together, some of them loosely tying together. But take the time to go back and look at fourth house and 12th house and read about that, and fifth house even, okay? And use that Taurus energy to your advantage, pile two. Thank you. If you feel inclined, please go watch pile one. If not, I will see you in maybe some of the other readings that I do, or later in the month for the full moon where it's releasing and letting go. Okay, thank you so much, and I'll see you later.